town of Kiltaglahar, a monument does stand to a proud and noble Leitrim man who lived and died for Ireland. He organized an army and he rose against the crown, so Irish men and women would no more be beaten down. And driven by desire to rekindle freedom's flame, he signed a proclamation that rejected England's claim to Ireland and her people, her destiny restored. The man was Sean McDiarmida, the pride of Corrinmore. Now on the shores of Loch McNean there stood a mansion grand, and the landlords that did dwell there were amongst the cruelest in the land. 39 families Lord Tottenham did rout, and later Colonel Adamson 100 more cast out. The pain of these evictions young McDiarmid saw firsthand, and there and then the rebel vowed to one day make a stand. I'll rid the Irish nation of their likes forevermore. The pledge of Sean McDiarmida, the pride of Corrinmore. So he planned a revolution, preached the fiery gospel of the free, promised an end to persecution till the time was right to strike for liberty. Then one Easter Monday morning he realized his plan, when poets stood with playwrights and rose up with the working man to fight the forces of King George and set the nation free. Though he knew deep in his heart it could not end in victory, but through the glorious madness of a rising doom to fail, he hoped his deeds would resurrect the spirit of the Gael. For 6 long days they battled till they could take no more. Enough, said Sean McDiarmida, the pride of Corrinmore. On General Maxwell's orders they took him from his cell, and he hobbled to that prison yard where 13 of his comrades fell. Then they placed a blindfold on those eyes of cobalt blue. He stood there to attention, for his dreams would now come true. And when those Sherwood foresters took aim on that grey dawn, their bullets would ensure the rebel's legacy lived on. His thoughts returned to Leitrim and MacNean's lonely shore. Then they martyred Sean McDiarmida, the pride of Corrinmore. And just as he had intended, his death brought life to the cause. Soon years of tyranny ended, new Irish ways and Irish laws. In the town of Kiltaglahar, a monument still stands to honour you, McDiarmida, who lived and died for Ireland. And has yourself this sacrifice turned out to be in vain? For the Ireland that you died for is in bondage once again. And those who climb on stages to commend your noble deeds have crucified your people through austerity and greed. The bailiffs have returned again, evictions by the score. Where are you, Sean McDermott, the pride of Curranmore? Oh, and will your likes be seen again round MacNean's plundered shore? We need you, Sean McDermott, the pride of Curranmore.